Hello guys, I bought a computer a few weeks ago and it was a pre-built. The CPU got too hot. It got over 70 degrees when I was just playing World of Warcraft. So I decided to get a new chassis and rebuild my computer pretty much. And also the pre-built had a few, I would say errors. I had to do a lot of things by myself. I bought a computer that was supposed to be tested and everything, but I don't know, man. The Ryzen processors, they get a bit hotter than I'm used to. My old processor, it was idling at 36 degrees Celsius, of course, not Fahrenheit. So from 36 to 70, it didn't feel right. So I had to make a lot of adjustments by myself. I got the temperature down to around 48, 50 degrees when idling, and that was pretty much what I could do. I undervolted the CPU and I changed a lot of things to make it work. I even adjusted the fans so they work properly. And in the end, I decided to just change the chassis because I think the main problem was the chassis. I also ended up changing the power supply and added a new fan. And as you can see, I pre-installed it. This is all the parts for this build. Here is a better look at the motherboard. Beautiful, isn't it? I'm removing the radiator. And now the screws for the motherboard. I realized I had to remove the fan because it was blocking the motherboard.
Could there be a hidden screw? I wonder.
Can do hole in honey.
I found the last screw. Hidden.
Okay. Oh, and we're done.
Don't touch any circuits. Okay, it's loose.
As you can see, the motherboard is out and it's into the new chassis. And I'm assembling it. It was a bit tricky since I didn't remove the AIO. Because I thought there would be more problems if I did that. So I just let it be there and I just swapped it over with the help of my girlfriend. And it was okay. Now I will put back the plate I removed to find the hidden screw on the motherboard.
Public of games. Here we go.
Okay, now I have assembled all the cables, as you can see here. They're all in. It was a bit tricky since I have both Corsair fans and I have
Asus fans. So I had to read some in the manual. But it worked. Now I will do some cable management. I have to admit, this wasn't the perfect cable management or the best I've ever done, but I did it quick. I did this swapping in about 2 hours, so I just wanted to get to test the system before I did the proper cable management. And I'm also gonna add some parts later, so I'm gonna have to redo it all over again. So I have to say though, building in this chassis was really satisfying. I've only built in older chassis because it was like 5 years ago since I did my last build, and I have to admit, we've come a long way. Not my finest work, but it works. Pretty good. Started on the first boot, no problems at all. And it's looking good.
You step into my arena, this is the reality check.
I went with the Asus ROG colors, red and black. I thought it looked good. Hope you guys enjoy.